All right, it's been a while since I've done one of these. I just finished washing now Michelle's Raptor, and had a significant change in life, mainly car driven in the last few weeks, and so I was washing the car, and I don't contrive a lot of this stuff. Like, it's not like I had a plan to make this video. I just do things when it seems right, when it feels right. When I feel like there's something that needs to be said, or something that I need to share, or something I just want to get out, I do these type of videos. Where I guess this is now episode 12 of the This Is Me series, of just keeping people, or letting people in on my life. No agenda. No, you know, there's no reason to do it other than I just find that when I keep doing this stuff, crazy stuff just keeps happening. You know, I let people in on it and give up the fear that somebody's going to think I'm stupid, or somebody's going to think less of me, or think or I'm giving people a way to really know how to come at me or how to attack, and just give up all that fear and just put it out there. And then what I've found is that it seems to have given other people permission to do the same. It's like when I go around to different places and I meet with different people, I think people can just smell it on me. There's just this never happened to me before in my life, before I started sharing my story and sharing where I'm at, the pros and cons and the wins and losses. And before I started doing that, I never ever encountered a situation where you get a group of people that would sit down and share. And it seems to happen to me all the time. Not sappy, lovey crap, but real. You know, real relationship, real connection. And so I'm going to let you in on something. This is my vision board that I put together here for my business class. That I'm going to share this with you. I've never actually had a blueprint to update anybody on my life, and it's going to seem hokey here right in the beginning. But if you stick with me, I would encourage everybody to do something like this. This is not my style. I'm not artistic. I'm not one to write things down, but this is sort of forced on me by going through the curriculum of this what's called my business course, and it's life-changing. I had to make a new one here this past week because my old one, the one I did in 2015, has literally, it was supposed to be like this big grand vision for my life. And it was 100% realized. So everything on my side of the board was done. And so I had to redo it and had to do a new update of my vision and what I want. And it's much simpler than the last one. There are a lot less cars on it than there was in the last one. And I think I have a better blueprint for what my life looks like, you know, in the next 10, 15, 20 years. But who knows? Maybe I'll realize this vision board in 2 years again, and we'll have to make another one. Yeah, I guess one can only dream. So let me rewind a bit and explain why I even did this. I'd mentioned this in one of the wash videos not long ago, where I talked about this, and I've talked about this quite a bit off and on in videos as I'm doing. I even shared one video of a coaching session with my business coach Rick. I like to think I'm not a gullible dude. For whatever reason, I've always been open to mentorship, and whenever that right person enters my life, it's not like I sought it out or had this great skill set to go find somebody to be a mentor. It's just, I think I was always willing to listen and then choose whether or not whatever that person, whatever people are telling me, it makes sense. You know, I've done this a lot in detailing, where I like to think I have several different mentors. Some I've met, some I haven't. And, you know, I've taken different processes, developed my own processes, and then make an educated decision on how to apply it and what makes sense, instead of just blindly following one person or another, instead taking and listening to those that believe something similar to me, and then applying it, and then creating my own system around that. And I've done that in all things in life. And so, excuse me, I guess I got a cold coming on here. But anyway, Rick Corbin was inserted into my life not long ago. I've told this story a few times where essentially what happened is I took this business course that I didn't want to take, and it just blew my mind. I think the reason why it blew my mind so much is because it was very, you know, very timely, and that I just opened myself up to the world on YouTube and through the forums and on my car journals, and then I built I was building the Obsessed Garage website. And I had a very unclear vision for what connectivity meant. Where was this all going? You know, what am I doing with this whole sharing thing? I'm making all these videos, investing all this time and effort. Shoot, even Michelle gave me an ultimatum at some point and said, "Hey, I'm with you on this, but you have to figure out what it is." You know, not even make money, but what is the point of all of this? And I wasn't very clear for a long time. And so having a coach help me clarify that has made a big difference in my life. So I mentioned in a Wash video not long ago about, hey, you know, Rick, I asked Rick about maybe offering a coaching curriculum or offering a class, the same class that I took, and maybe in the future offering a class for those that maybe aren't business owners but are either key employees, or you're up and coming, you're aspiring, or you don't have a desire to own your business, you just want to be the best you can be. Maybe you're an engineer, or you're a doctor working for a hospital or something like that, or just somebody who really aspires to better themselves. Could we make a curriculum? I haven't addressed that yet, but we did put a course together for my business, and I was very loose about this. I didn't want to pitch anybody on it, because honestly, my fear was that I'm the only idiot that's getting anything out of this stuff. And that, you know, because I've seen lots of people that got a lot out of it from the different courses I've taken, but I feel like I've bought in more than anybody that I've come across, and the fruit of that has been significant. And where I think I'm headed is at least significant for me. You know, whether it's from a developing relationship with people all over the world perspective, to creating a business around doing what I like to do, doing what stimulates me. It's not all about doing what you like to do. It's doing about what gets you going. You know, what you're really passionate about. What doesn't, you know, when you do need to put in lots of effort and lots of work, when does it not feel like that? You know, and chasing that vision and chasing that picture of what that looks like is what Rick has helped develop some clarity around. So I just sort of haphazardly threw it out there, said, hey, if anybody would like to take the course, if you've seen a change in me over the years, you know, people that have watched these videos, we're going to do it online. And I was a little apprehensive about that. I'm like, yeah, I did it in person, so I don't know if that's going to work. And so we're going to do it online, where everybody is on screen and we can see each other, and you're doing it from your living room on your computer. And so my fear was that we wouldn't get the same message. My other fear, again, was that I'm crazy, and then people would take this and think, you know, if it's an idiot, they're not going to get anything out of this. And oh boy. Man, we have 14 people in this version. I think 10 of them or 11 people are from the sort of Obsessed Garage, and me just mentioning that comment, I had 20 some people interested. But you know, it's Wednesday nights for 3 hours, and it's a pretty significant time commitment. It will change your life, but the impact that it's had on me by going through it with other people, I'm not facilitating it, I'm not making any money on it. I just thought it would be cool to do and to see if, you know, others got out of it what I got out of it. And the guys that are in it, I'm sure they're probably going to watch this video. It's just been absolutely life-changing. Just even in the first couple of days, I could see people changing. You can hear their voice change. It's impossible to explain. But regardless, I think that this is something that is extremely viable, to take this community of obsessed people. There are, you know, 100 and some odd thousand of us. Of that, I would guess probably 50% of the people that subscribe to my YouTube channel are obsessed. And then another probably 50% of the not 50% at least aspire to be. And so that's a large number of people. We can do 25 people at a time or so. But if you want to do it, if you want to get in it this second time around, the first time is fantastic. The second time, I'm sure, will be even better. We've gotten all the technology ironed out. It's really, really fantastic. So that's, I think that's part of my vision, my long-term vision, is to be able to connect. So I think that's my place in this world, to take complicated things and connect them to something. So we have all these products, right? I have all these products in here, cabinets, flooring, all this stuff that I have an interest in and a passion for. And so I have these products that I've now gained access to, now that I'm able to connect lots of people to these great, and a lot of times very obscure products. And then I have all these great people that are watching and listening to what I'm saying. And I'm hoping that most people aren't blindly following my opinion. It's not even an opinion, it's an experience. I'm hoping that people watch it and then develop their own decision-making process around what I'm saying, just sharing mine. And I know a lot of younger guys are probably modeling, but I would hope that everybody's modeling after their own way of learning, or their own way of sort of digging into what I'm saying and the products that I'm using and things like that, to then make an educated decision on whether it makes sense or not. And in some cases, some people say, I don't want to do the process. I don't want to go through the process. I'm just going to follow that. And I'm going to use that, that car washing package, that wheel cleaning kit or something like that, or the pressure washer. And I'm just going to follow Matt. And I know that he's charging retail and he's not running all kinds of sales and stuff, but I'm just going to buy it because I know that it's going to work and I want to support whatever it is he's doing. And that's happened a ton, and it's been really humbling for that, to watch that and to be a part of it and really to be responsible for it. Because I share a really significant sense of responsibility for all of this. So the idea here with coaching, and there's no sales pitch here. If you want to do it, it will literally change your life. And now I know for a fact it will, because a bunch of people have gone through it that are a lot like me, and if not carbon copies, and their minds are just blown. And so the next course is January 18th. January 18th it starts. It's Wednesday night, 6:30 to 9:30. So just shoot me an email, matt@obsessedgarage.com. I'll send you the link of what the course entails. It's 9 weeks, 8 weeks with 1 week off in order to do your vision board. And so it's 9 weeks of really intense, 3 hours at a time with 2 30-minute coaching sessions a week. And it's, you have to be a business owner, you have to be a decision maker, a CEO or business owner, in order to be able to take this, in order to get anything out of it. But man, it's incredible. And so the vision board behind me is one of the weeks, and I hope Rick doesn't give me a hard time about this, but a vision board's one of those things that you do. And the thought process there is that whatever you put down, whatever you can dream up, money no object, whatever you can dream up, whatever you could possibly want, put it down. Don't time, distance, money, just completely ignore that. Go buy some magazines. I went to the store to buy some magazines, but magazines can't contain me anymore. They don't have in them what I'm looking for. So I had to go to Google Images in order to print this out. So it doesn't look quite as pretty as my last one did. But if the thesis here, the idea here is that if you do it, then this stuff will happen. And I thought it was a load of crap the first time I did it, but man, it's so true. It's so true. So I'm going to take you through this, and this will give you an idea of where I'm at. I'm going to be very real. I'm going to be very candid. I'm going to share what my vision is, what I want, what my hopes and dreams are. And so this will give you an opportunity to either give me a hard time about it, or to either share it, or just to know a little bit more about me and what I'm thinking, and what this whole Obsessed Garage, Obsessed Wealth, what this whole thing is all about, and how I'm thinking about it and why I'm thinking through it. So let me get set up here and let's walk through the board. All right, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to cut me out of the image here, and I'm just going to point, so that way we can stay focused on the board, and I'll take you through what each one of these things means. I don't know how long this is going to take. We're supposed to present it in the class for 3 minutes, but I'm gonna just do the whole thing. If it takes me an hour, it takes me an hour. But I'm gonna go through this and let you in. So generally, this is Michelle and I's our lives, which is very very telling for what works for us. I get lots of comments at times saying, you know, don't spend any time with your family and all this stuff. And, you know, that's partly true. I mean, Michelle and I are very independent. And so we have very independent lives, but we always come back together and it really works well for us. We don't fight, we don't argue, we don't have issues, at least generally don't. And so we have very clear visions that kind of come together. And actually, I'll restate that. I have a very clear vision and Michelle is very chill. She just kind of goes with it. So we'll start in the upper left, kind of work our way around here and talk through this. So, you know, Michelle is like, gosh darn Mother Teresa. You know, if you've watched the other parts of the series, you know, I know I'm an engineer, I know I'm a science guy. I really struggle with the whole idea of, you know, creator and all that stuff. But, you know, I'm a believer. I don't really have a need to walk around talking to people about it. It's just not my thing. Other people have that gift of mercy and how to lead people to God and to faith. But it's just not my skill set. I hope that people see it on me. You can just see how I am in this world, and maybe that's not the right way to do it, but this is just the way that I found it worked. I used to beat myself up over it all the time. Michelle, that's her skill set, is to, you know, she wants to leave a legacy, right? She's big on commitment and, you know, digging into the Word every day, and so she's a very, very, very strong, a much stronger Christian than I am, but that's, you know, that's her thing. She's very very thoughtful about how she approaches other people and is much more merciful than me. So on the spiritual gifts finder, she scores high on mercy and things like that, and mine, I score like literally zero on that stuff, as you I'm sure you guys know. So she's a lot about personal growth and commitment. You know, putting God first, you know, is something she cut out here. Family, obviously very important to everybody, but she put family here. She's really into she's in much better shape than I am. So she's, right now anyway, I still beat her though in the workouts. That's all that matters. At least most of the time. So she's talked about fun and balance, and she's again about us all coming together as a team. You know, Michelle, I've probably never mentioned this before, but she has, I think she has 7 state championships, 5 as a coach, 2 as a player. So she's a winner. She just wins at everything. If I play in ping pong, I freaking lose. But she's about team and building teams, and, you know, so teamwork. She put teamwork makes the dream work. Her big thing is she wants to go to the Holy Land. She wants to travel, which is a real problem because I freaking hate traveling. So we'll have to figure out something there. I'm sure I'll have to make some sacrifices. She has already made significant sacrifices for me, so I'm probably going to have to go to, you know, Tahiti or Bora Bora or something like that. She's a photographer, so she does that. She's very, very good at that. My guess is she'll end up finding some way to coach. She put this, you know, why sports are good for kids. So my guess is she's going to be doing lots of coaching of kids sports, which I'm not particularly gifted at doing. And so she's, as you can see, hers is about faith, health, travel, family. And she put family in the middle because, you know, that obviously family is important to me as well. We put family closer to threading all of this stuff that we have going on as a family unit. But she's also a believer in getting things done, making things happen. And then this in the center kind of speaks to both of us as we're just doing us. You do you, and we really don't worry about what other people are doing. We do our own thing. So how this connects to the business side of things. And this is just, I think, where we're at in life, is that I think about business and caring for the family and providing. She thinks about taking care of and making sure the family is spiritually sound. You know, that's her role. Her role is to keep us all on path, you know, get us to church, get us together, get us having dinner together. Her mission is to raise these great kids. At least that's what her focus has been, and to keep me under control. You know, and she has full permission to do that. And so, you know, Michelle is, I mean, she was, she graduated valedictorian of college, you know, of her college and Lynn University. She's just a born winner, you know, so she's made a huge sacrifice. She decided not to go to medical school. She decided to sacrifice, and this was her choice, not mine. It wasn't part of my financial plan for her to stay at home and take care of the kids. When we had Ryan, she gave that all up and said, I want to stay at home. I said, I don't think that's a good idea, because, you know, you're worth a lot more money working. And she said, I just feel led to do this. And we made that decision. It was the best decision we ever could have made in our lives. So here is something. So my side of the board has changed so much, because for the longest time, you know, this side of the board had BMWs and Porsches and cars and garages and all of that stuff. And it's changed a lot for me, you know, probably because, you know, I had a house. It was very important to me to have my own business, to be independent. So when I made this board, I was still at Merrill Lynch. I was still an employee, had a great business, had a great life, and I screwed that all up. Threw it all out the door, and then I had partners, and everything was great. All I had to do was go into work and call some clients and then do some weird marketing. But I just didn't feel like that was right. I had this sense, and forgive me, I had this sense that I'm meant for something great. I don't know what it is. I didn't know if it meant that I should have been CEO of Merrill Lynch or something. And forgive the arrogance in this, but I would tell Michelle this all the time and say, look, I feel like I'm destined for something great. And I really feel like this whole accident of God coming in, kicking me in the head, having me go literally insane, and then through the process of rebuilding my life, with after the diagnosis of obsessive compulsive disorder, and figuring out what, you know, what is my mission field, if you will, because it's not in Haiti, you know, it's not in China. My mission field is, I think I've figured it out. It's just connecting with whatever people I'm supposed to connect with, and that's what's happening, I think. So me doing me has created this. I put a roll of thread here, and forgive me, I probably didn't do as good of a job explaining Michelle's side, but I'm going to do my best of explaining where I'm at and how this all connects. You know, in the beginning, I had this disjointed thing when I did this 2 years ago. I wanted a business, right? And I wanted to connect wealth management, which I have this passion for, and this gift set for, you know, financial organization, for digging through, you know, investment products. And then, because it really, in a lot of investments, you have mutual funds and annuity, all this stuff. They're just products. Stocks are just a product, something that you can purchase, much like I can purchase some Iron X to remove the iron embedded in my clear coat. Same thing with investments. We have a problem, and then we go and we look for something to solve the problem, and it's just what I'm gifted to do, is solve problems. I don't know why, it just is. I'm not gifted to go help somebody if they, you know, broke their ankle. It's not my deal. I'm better gifted for this little niche that I have. And so, a lot of people ask me a lot of times, how do you do so much? Right? There's no way you can still go to your office and get the stuff done, or something has to give, right? And the one thing that has given, you can probably see it on the camera, is that, you know, I was in fantastic shape and now I'm not. So I need to refocus. And CrossFit just works for me. I have a blast doing it. There's still the competitive aspect of it. I'm pretty decent at it, even though I'm taller and longer, and generally you're better off being shorter and stouter to be decent at CrossFit. But I never have an issue going. It's always, I enjoy going. It's never like I drive by the gym and say, man, I don't want to go there. I always want to be there. So getting in shape is something that's important. I need to do. I'm focused on it. And after my meeting with Adam Vitale, and we had dinner, not a meeting, but we had dinner. He's owner of Adam's Polishes, and he told me his story and where he's at. And it just motivated me to get my crap together and get back in shape. Because, you know, if I'm not healthy, I can't do any of this crap. So the vision here is that I have a roll of thread. And so this is how we deal with time, time and effort. If I do one thing and it connects to multiple things, and so I put it in a circle here, I don't go crazy. If wealth management connects to Obsessed Garage somehow, then I'm only doing one thing. You know, in fact, I used to spend 90% of my time marketing to find new clients. To go out and find somebody else to let me manage their money for them, or to help them, you know, figure out a better way to choose investments, right? And or to help craft a financial plan for them. And so I used to spend all of my time finding people. Well, now I can make a video on YouTube and people show up in wealth management. You know, they show up and they buy stuff. They buy products from me. They show up to help me detail something or buy detailing products. So it all connects. So it all threads. And so this is a big change for me. This is through coaching. I thought there needed to be this silo. I thought there needed to be wealth management here, Obsessed Garage there, and then there was me in the middle. And I needed to connect them somehow, but I needed to be very artful of that. I needed to be very crafty because I didn't want to turn anybody off. Right? I didn't want anybody to make that connection. I wanted it to happen naturally. Well, there is only one me, and this all stuff is all the same. So why doesn't it thread? Why doesn't it all connect? It's all the same thing. If I'm this obsessed with the organization of my drawers, then why, you know, there's a direct correlation to everything in my life. And so the thought process here is I want to thread different things. And I think there are several different businesses that come from this. One is providing solutions, not just detailing. Detailing is 1/10 of the stuff that goes in your garage. I'm interested in anything that goes in the garage. The garage is the anchor here. Flooring, cabinets, shelving, fans, AV, obviously detailing products, tools, cars, all that stuff connects. And so I have this vision for, and I don't know how close you guys can see in the picture, but this is a warehouse that goes to infinity, essentially. I have this vision for that, to provide solutions like nobody else provides them, with the detail of the information, vetting the products, and enjoying the heck out of it. Right now, just to give you a clue, this came, so the two businesses that really exist is YouTube is, I guess, a business. The wealth management is the most significant business, which will probably be eclipsed just because the volume of potential of placing product to people. Because I'm not retailing anything. I don't have any desire to retail, but to connect people to products, so to consult. So the consultative practice or thing that I'm building with the Obsessed Garage store, I think. So this year, let's see, I hit over, I hit well over $1 million in sales. So I'm probably like $1.8 million in sales this year. I just started it in January. So $1.8 million in sales at, you know, I don't know what the margins are, but 35% margins. You can do the math. That's a significant business. And I think that it's going to double and triple and double and triple. And I think that there's massive potential there, because all I'm doing is creating a place that I want to go to. Right, and it's not about me, but it's about my belief that, and that's what this is about here, that if I teach people the what, how, and why, you know, why am I doing this? Why, that's part of the reason why I'm doing this vision board. If I find more people that believe what I believe, you know, what I believe, that's what I put up here in the top, that you know, very, very few places understand that. And I stole this, I forget the guy's name, but there's a self-help guy that, I don't really watch self-help, but I found this on the, you know, when I just searched for this, what I believe, this thing popped up. I'm like, oh, that's pretty cool. And I started watching some videos that communicated what I was thinking, that the reason why people are buying stuff from my consultative business, the reason why people are trusting me with their money and wealth management, the reason why people are buying detailing packages from me is because they believe what I believe. You know, so, and the reason why a lot of people are watching this video is probably fairly similar. So YouTube, when I say YouTube is a business, I mean, just to put it into perspective, I make, you know, $2,500 bucks a month on YouTube. That'll probably grow. Other channels that get a lot more views make a lot more money. But YouTube is not the goal. So, you know, but it's still a business. I mean, it's still making, you know, $20,000 to $30,000 a year and growing. I think that's probably short-lived. So I'm not interested in just building and, you know, getting views and having people watch that. I really want to connect with people. And the most ultimate connection for me is whenever I come in and reorganize your financial life, or even not even reorganize, but in a lot of cases, just take over what you've been doing on your own, or somebody else has been doing for you that maybe you didn't trust or you didn't believe the same things. So again, this all threads, right? I have a vision to become independent, meaning that right now my wealth management business, I own my own practice. It's just me. I know I'm going to be hiring and I already have my guy. I'm sure some of you guys see him, you know, Jared Toops. My intent is to hire him if I can convince him to come down here to Florida. And then I'll be hiring probably shortly after that, because I think this is going to explode. Notice how I purposely haven't talked a lot about wealth management. I wouldn't be able to handle it if I turned that spigot on. There's also a lot of issues with compliance and me even doing this stuff, and so I'm evolving them. I have a very clear vision for how I'm going to connect this. ObsessedWealth.com is now online. It sucks, but it works. It looks cool, but the content isn't there yet. So the content is the key to be able to create content to share with you people what I do and how I do it. So I have a really cool plan, or a really great plan for that, that I think a lot of you guys that care about this stuff, whether you're going to hire me or not, are going to be interested in going through that process and me sharing that. So independence will help that, because then, you know, compliance will leave me alone. So I'm probably 3 or 4 years away from independence, which means that I would still clear through Raymond James, but I would no longer be on the Raymond James corporate side. I would be Raymond James independent, because that also connects here to this picture, which you can't see. But I want to build a compound. I have this vision for two destinations. I've mentioned this before, a destination in the Carolina Mountains, a destination in Florida, and then other destinations. Once I figure out how to build those destinations, I can build other destinations. Again, this whole idea of connecting people to product, people to people, whether it's coaching, you know, CEOs to smart young talent, and then connecting people together with a common interest. For instance, making a place in the mountains in the Carolinas where there are, you know, 100 homes there, where you lease your week or 2 weeks. I shared a little bit about that in the video in the past, but creating destinations, because it's, to me, it's all about community. And that's what this picture here is, of a marathon, you know, with me and everybody else, just we're all running in the same direction. I think that, you know, by putting yourself out there, by connecting with people, I think there's an opportunity to create a movement, and to create movement in a positive way. And anytime you create a movement, there's always opposition. But if the movement is big enough, the opposition doesn't even matter. They can stand on the sidelines and spectate. Again, this is the mountains here. Driving is of interest to me. I'll be doing more driving. I'd like to evolve my driving skills. I'll probably hire a coach or something like that to become you know, I'd like to become an expert driver. I'm not an expert. You know, I'm a novice. above average novice. And I know I rag on myself a lot about not being any good at driving. I'm really not as bad as I make myself out to be. I know I've driven with many other people. I know where I stand. You know, I know where I stand, and a lot of it has to do with my fear of my own mortality. So values plus vision plus wisdom equals passion. You know, passion is what this is all about. I'm passionate about my family. I just am passionate about it a different way than most people expect me to be. And I can't share everything on a YouTube video or a YouTube channel. Notice cars haven't become as important. So this is my GT3 RS. I mean, that's been the vision, that's been the passion, that's been the pursuit. I like to think of this as the mechanical version of me as a human being, you know, what I aspire to be anyway. And then, you know, balance is key. You know, balance for me, being present, being balanced, and not chasing it so hard that I can't, I can't function like I would like. So that's my vision board, and I thought better than me just sitting here talking to you, I'd put this up here and just explain a little bit about me and my life and what I'm thinking. I honestly think, and one of the big things that's changed for me is I used to quantify everything. So if I could give anybody any lesson of my mistake in the past, it's I've lived my entire life in a destination. Right, so I'm gonna go to engineering school and get a degree. And once I got that, I was like, okay, you know, I was already beyond that before it was even done. So then I'm gonna make $100,000. And I did that really early in life. And then it's like, oh, okay, now I'm done. And it's like, get this car, get that car, get this family, you know, do all these things. And my fatal flaw is that through this whole destination, this whole quantifying everything, this whole goal setting, which I thought was what you're supposed to do, I never enjoyed any of it. I was never present for any of it. I've never had balance. I've never had any of that. I've just had success after success after success after success. And every single time I got there, when I was searching for whatever car it was, while I'm signing on the dotted line to purchase that car, I'm thinking about the next car instead of just enjoying it, being present. So living life as a destination is very different for me. So I think that Obsessed Garage as a consultative business can become massive. I thought this from the very beginning when I started to see some traction, largely because it's what I wanted to consume. I wanted to be a part of. I want to buy from a place like this. And I get now that it's really hard to do. And very, very few people have the passion for it. And even if you did, then you've got to get out of your own way to do it. And so I've lucked into that of getting out of my own way to do it. So I have a revenue business of a few million dollars, which means that, you know, I'm going to make, you know, quite a bit of money off of it. So there's some financial success that comes from that. And I don't have any quantity or any number that I'd like to do or like to hit. I have a financial plan, and you know, so money isn't the motivation, because if money were the motivation, then I'd be back in destination again, destination land, trying to reach a certain level. Instead, I'm just enjoying the heck out of the whole process of being present. I wasn't present like I would like to be through this process of getting my GT3 RS and my Raptor and selling the other cars, but I'm there now. I can feel it. I can feel being there. That I'm enjoying this process. I'm gonna build a garage here on property. I didn't put it on the board because it's so minimal in the grand scheme. It was such an important thing to me. So important that I've postponed it and postponed it and postponed it. And now I know when it'll be time. I can't quantify that. But it's just gonna be, that's gonna be a blip on the radar. Doesn't even factor into the vision board. It's gonna be awesome. I'm gonna share the process. I'm gonna make lots of friends, make lots of connections, put lots of amazing products in it. And probably the garage is probably gonna make me a bunch of money by sharing that. But it's not about that. It's about going to Rupes and when I don't belong there, and then hooking up with Adam and Phil Hugh and Jeremy from Shine Supply and the guys from Esoteric and my good friend Levi from the Rag Company and going to dinner and us sitting there pouring out just whatever's going on and sharing it. And I think I have something to do with that. Not me, not ego. I think because stuff just keeps happening all over the place. And so I think this whole thing is not about destination. I think it's about just enjoying the ride, staying stimulated, being passionate, and enrolling people along the way. And if you enroll people, the money will come, the money will be a result, the cars will come, the houses will come, whatever you want, you'll get. But if you're present when it comes, you'll enjoy it so much more. And when I say you, I mean me, talking about myself here. I'm talking to myself here, getting this out of my head. Because ultimately, the whole vision of this channel, the reason why it started, the reason why I continue to do it, was it's therapy for me to get out of my own head and connect with people. And I know that making this video will connect with some people. Me sharing and letting you in on this is not comfortable for me. I'm good at sitting here talking and just continuing to talk and talk and talk, but it's still uncomfortable. So I hope those of you that made it through it, I hope you honor that. And I know some people will make it 2 minutes in and they'll just sort of throw some crap out there. And, you know, whatever, it comes with the territory. But if you want to change your life, not from a self-help perspective, not to get money or to get goals or to organize something, but to truly figure out how to be enlightened about figuring out how to build the business, finding people that believe what you believe. Those people aren't hiding. That's a quote from Rick. You just have to figure out how to be in relationship with people. And that relationship has many different avenues and different definitions. You already know enough people in this world to connect you with enough people to be as successful as you could ever possibly imagine. So if you want to do the course, again, no sales pitch. I hope you get this. The reason why I'm doing this is to let you in, not to pitch you. Because ultimately, if you do take the course, that means I'm going to take it again. I'm going to take it with you. And that means 3 hours a week of time that I've been saying this for a long time. I'm going to have to eat these words about, you know, people saying you don't have enough time. I don't have enough energy to do everything that I want to do. And so that's where threading things becomes so important. Figuring out how to leverage your time. The next step for me is going to be figuring out how to manage people as I include others in this crazy thing that I've accidentally created. So if you'd like to take the course, starting January, it'll be January 18th, Wednesday night, 6:30 to 9:30. Just shoot me an email, matt@obsessedgarage.com. I'll connect you with Rick. I'll send you a syllabus of what the course entails. It's $2,500, $2,450. And it'll freaking change your life, and you'll be standing in front of a camera talking about your vision board, sharing it with the rest of the world without any fear of all of the stuff that's kind of come with it. So anyway, thanks to all of you for being a part of this. I got a freaking blood hand shirt. Just crazy stuff that I was all connected to putting myself out there. And I get to do some of the greatest stuff, some of the stuff that I never would have dreamt of doing, and now I do it every single day. So anyway, thanks for watching this stuff, and as always, you know, stay tuned for more crazy. It's only going to get nuttier. Because what happens when the force pulls you back, your foot naturally comes off the gas. You have to keep your foot to the floor.